grew up in New York proper, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
I'm born in New York.
Born in New York. Your dad worked for NBC.
That's right. He played piano and arranged. He was an arranger and a vocal coach. He worked for Toscanini, and he was director of the Children's Hour radio show, and he worked with Jack Benny and all kinds of things that were happening at that radio station. And my mother was a violinist also.
Yeah.
She played with Xavier Cugat. Right. So I met all these people. I met Milton Berle, the comedian, mm-hmm. and Pearl Bailey, actually. And I later worked with her, and she remembered me and my father and everything. R was the first guy I actually heard on the alto when I was in Denver on that basketball scholarship. And I thought that R was so incredible, and I wanted to play alto.
Really badly, huh? Yeah.
Well, he was so good looking.
He thought, if that's the way.
He was so handsome. There were so many women sitting at the bar looking at him.
Yeah.
And I said, what a life this guy must have. You know, my God, he could have any woman in this bar. I didn't want to do the casual, what you call casuals. We call them club dates in New York. Yeah. Weddings, bar mitzvahs, and stuff like that. Yeah, I wanted to avoid that, like with Poison. Tito Puente was very, very, very busy at that time in New York. He was playing seven nights a week, and he was recording during the day. He was doing so much stuff. Tito loved jazz. He was very respectful to guys who could play jazz, and he hired Jazz Cat. That's part of the reason I went to try to play with some of the Latin bands, because there was so much hip-hop.
A lot more happening.
Song. Yeah, mm-hmm. It was much more fun, and you could make a living. Right, well, Joe Henderson was a big influence on me when I met him. He lived in Brooklyn, right near me. We used to hang out a lot. I played in his big band and small groups. And Chick Corea was a good friend. He came to New York, and I met him as soon as he got to New York, and I knew he was exceptional, and I helped him get some gigs to start off. Buddy was amazing. People respected him, and great musicians would come out to hear him.
Oh, yeah?
I remember Miles coming and out, and all the drummers would come out and hear him whenever we played in New York. So he was high, very, you know, respected. He always gave you a good show if you come out to see him. He didn't know half the people in the band. He didn't care to know them. You know, he was so involved with himself. And for instance, I played the West Side Story album. I had a solo on one of the records. Producer asked him, who's that alto player? And he didn't even know who I was.
Thank you. going out with Bob Minster's Big Band. In fact, we're probably right in the middle of your solo.
But let me shut up.
In a lullaby.